I'm feeling extremely sad because my future is not very bright.
After the fall of Kabul, I see my dreams as shattered, and also I'm really heartbroken.
I lost anything I had. I lost my 20 years. I lost even not just the past, I lost the future as well.
Is there any difference between girls and boys? Even in every religion in the world, it is said that women and men are equal. There is no discrimination between them. Then why they're making this discrimination between us? Everything has stopped. I cannot go to the academy. I cannot learn English. All of my dreams are ruined. There is nothing left.
We know that education is a human right of all children. It improves our societies, it brings more peace and harmony. We also know that it has economic advantages. It uplifts the society from poverty.
Taliban just asked the women to wear burqas. They just asked women not to go outside. It's just like being robots and eating and sleeping, watching television. So it's so hard for us because we are the new generation.
Afghan women are demanding the right to choose their own future.
I am from new generation. I wasn't born to just eat, sleep and stay at home. I want to go to school. I want to do something for the development of my country.
To be honest, it's not an easy situation for the women to stand for their right.
Their protests are met with tear gas, rifle butts and metal clubs.
Many girls are actually fearing of being raped or being forcibly married. It's really about survival right now.
What we can hope for is the help of international communities.
We really need to try and exert some form of diplomatic pressure to ensure that women's rights and freedom are included as critical and central elements of any kind of deal that's happening in Afghanistan.
Just support us and be by our side.
For the women in Afghanistan to know that they are not alone in this, that we are also here to support their moves, their vision. We are also here to preserve the progress and the rights that they have gained.
Before the 15th August, we think that we were in paradise and now we are in hell. Our everyday life now seems like a dream for us, a dream that we cannot reach again. So my message to the world is, do not take anything for granted.
Oh. Sentiments of the 90s, you know, that feeling of, you know, girls can't go, it's not safe. 5 years go past and they're still not going, you know, and they're not letting high school kids go to high school. What does that mean then for further education, which we know is the crucial part in changing anything?
Yeah, that's right.
Is education.
And but what was interesting was hearing some of those voices, because I think we made this point at the time the Taliban came back into power, that they're taking over a different country. So they're actually...
So the fight against them will be stronger.
Yeah, I suspect they're going to face a different kind of...
Well, you said that on the night.
Yeah. Now, that doesn't mean that they won't be able to get...
Well, how powerful are they? Like,
yeah,
it depends.
That will all depend. And I suspect what will also... The real question will be the extent to which the world really cares.
Because the US officials met with the Taliban on the weekend and they said, you know, they had productive talks, but what that means... They talked about terrorism, security, women and girls.
Yeah, yeah.
But
I mean... What levers do you have to pull exactly? So that's going to depend a bit on how much the Taliban care about being part of the international community, because then you get some leverage. It's going to depend on money, so money that comes into the country, all of those sorts of things.
They tried to convince people. It didn't last long, though, did it?
No, that's right.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.